categorically states that for true federalism in this country to thrive, there is need for a total government to be in place. Not being in place, it must have its autonomy to fund itself and to operate itself. And that is to justify Nigeria as a true federal state. Now, apart from this, I also want to implore the parliamentarians across the nation to see that for true democratic process and structure, there is need for them to pass the bill for local government autonomy without any delay. Not only this, but also, we need to also sensitize our people and to let them know the positive effect of local government autonomy. In every other climes of the world, local government is more respected and more, funded in order to service the people at the grassroots. One, it is the government that is closer to the grassroots. It is the government that services the oppressed. It is the government that services the downtrodden. And it is the government that develops the grassroots and also brings the growth, the desired growth to the grassroots. Moreover, we all know every politics is local, and every development starts from the local, because revenue is from the local. There is no federal government that generates revenue. All revenue starts from the local. The petrol that all of us, which is the mainstay of Nigeria economy today, is first of all discovered at Olebri in the south side, the present day Warwick Bayelsa. And you see that it belongs to one particular local government. The gold in Osun today belongs to Lesa West and Lesa East. That belongs to one particular local government. Ajakuta today belongs to a particular local government. Every economy that sustains every nation is located in every local government. As such, there is need for autonomy for this local government in order for them to develop and grow. There is need for local government to be recognized not only on paper, it should be recognized in the practical terms. Now, it is not the duty of the governors, it is the duty of the people and those people that were elected at the parliament to effect the change, the amendment. You know, because you elected them to service you, and therefore, they were supposed to be from one local government or the other. It is their primary responsibility to ensure that this bill is passed and the amendment for the local government autonomy is effected in due course without any delay.